king of Egypt, and he pursued the Israelites as they were leaving confidently and defiantly. The Egyptians chased them with all the horses and the war chariots of Pharaoh, his horsemen and his army, and they overtook them as they camped by the sea beside Pihahiroth, in front of Baal and Zephon. As Pharaoh approached the Israelites, looked up and saw the Egyptians marching after them, and they were very frightened. So the Israelites cried out to the Lord. They have said to Moses, "Is it because there were no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? What is this that you have done to us by bringing us out of Egypt? Did we not say to you in Egypt, 'Leave us alone, let us serve the Egyptians'? For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians as slaves than to die in the wilderness." Then Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Take a stand. Be firm, confident, and undismayed, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For those Egyptians whom you have seen today, you will never see them again. The Lord will fight for you. Why only need to keep silent and remain calm?" The Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry to me? Tell the sons of Israel to move forward towards the sea. And as for you, lift up your staff, stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, so that the sons of Israel may go through the middle of the sea on dry land. As for me, hear this, I will harden the heart of the Egyptians, and they will go in the sea after them, and I will be glorified and honored through Pharaoh and all the army, and his war chariots and his horsemen." So, you know, when I looked at this scenario, the children of Israel, they were slaves, and they ended up being comfortable in that environment of slavery. And that also can happen to us as children of God, where we will become so discouraged and get used to uncomfortable situations because we feel that there is no way out for us. That we feel that we don't have any option just to continue in slavery, different types of slavery, different types of addictions. Or I have sinned, and what, I cannot change. God cannot forgive me. Let me continue in sin. Come to church, no one sees what I've done. Like, I cannot reverse what I've done. It is done, it is done. So the children of Israel felt so frustrated. They got used to this slavery, being there, serving the Egyptians. At least they had bread to eat, they had a place to sleep. If they died, they were raised there in Egypt. So it was fine for them. But God didn't want them to continue living like that. God hasn't called them to live in slavery and die somewhere in a foreign land without fulfilling the assignment that God has given to them, because they are a chosen nation. Amen. We are a chosen generation. We are a chosen nation. We might feel that we have no options at times. We might feel that we are surrounded. There is no way out. But this is not the end. And that's not what God wants for us. So, especially in this Tanya lockdown, I want to lie to you, when it was announced, I was shocked. I've never heard of anything like this. And I believe it's the same with everyone. Anxiety kicks in. I'm working from home. I'm still working from home.
Yeah.
You hear news, bad news. Companies are retrenching.
Yeah.
You become anxious. But praise God, I am a child of God and I have the word of God.
Amen.
Yeah. And God said, "I am watching over my weight to perform it." And God reminds me that I called you and you have a purpose. And you, my purpose is not for you to be destroyed in this pandemic.
Yeah.
So, children of God, this is the reminder. You might not, things might go well in this pandemic, but things may not be going well for somebody else that you know.
Yeah.
You know? And then sometimes the plans double, we have changed our plans. We had New Year's resolution for 2020, and then in March everything stopped.
Yeah.
We had New Year's resolution for 2021. We were looking forward to sitting and writing down our visions. What are we going to do? And then now we went to adjusted level 3. And then we don't know what to do. Some of us, we had to start homeschooling. Now we have this child that you only saw in the morning and in the evening, that you have to make sure he does his work and everything. And you are worried about this child's performance.
Right.
Things have changed, and change is very uncomfortable. Change brings anxiety. Change sometimes makes you insecure. This is the change that the children of Israel were experiencing.
Right.
But thank God for a leader like Moses,
amen,
who went and spoke to the children of Israel. God spoke after Moses. But you can see when Moses had a relationship with God, and he remembered God's promises. And then he went and spoke to the children of Israel. He spoke God's word and God's promises,
amen,
and God's principles.
Amen.
Listen to what Moses is saying. Do not be afraid. Take your stand. Take your stand. Be firm and confident and undismayed. Ephesians 6, where it talks about the armor of God, what does it say? It still speaks about taking a stand as children of God. With the belt of truth buckled around our waist, the truth of God must give us that confidence. The truth of the word of God will make the children of Israel to stand firm and be confident and be undismayed, because that's the truth. This is the end of the world. There's a pandemic. We are finished. It's the lies from the devil.
Yeah. Yeah.
So make sure that around our waist is a belt of truth, as children of God. And let us speak this truth on a daily basis, because God knows we need the encouragement daily.
Amen.
So he said to them,
yeah,
and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. God is fighting for us. He's accomplishing like something today for us.
Yes.
There is a battle that is being fought in the spiritual realm for us every day, so that we can see tomorrow.
Amen.
When I drove and went to work and came back home, there was a battle, and I was being protected by the angel of God. That's why I'm able to arrive at home and see the following day.
Amen.
In my sleep, God is fighting for me,
yes,
and you,
yes,
when you are sleeping. Amen. So it's important to make sure that we are closer to the truth of the way,
amen,
of God on a daily basis.
Yeah.
We cannot afford to neglect the will of God.
Amen.
Anxiety will come. Fear will come. But we are not supposed to stay here. So he said to them, you will accomplish and see the salvation of the Lord that he will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see, you have seen today, you will never see them again. This is a time of battle.
Yes.
And this is a battle that we need to stand against and be confident.
Right.
And this battle will pass. The same way as the Red Sea. When God spoke to Moses, I raised up your staff so that the Red Sea can open up for the children of Israel to pass through.
Yes.
That is the same instruction that God is giving us today. Because this is a battle. We are in a battle, and we are going to get out of this battle.
Yes.
We're going to arrive on the other side.
Yes.
But this will not be the last battle that we will ever face in our lives. So let us make sure that when we are in this battle, it's a time of practice and it's a time of learning. So that in the next battle that is coming, we are ready for it. We have learned something.
Right.
So Moses said to the children of Israel, the Lord will fight for you.
Hallelujah.
While you only keep silent and remain calm. When you keep silent, when you remain calm, it doesn't mean ignorant.
Right.
Or I'm silent, I'm calm, I won't wear a mask, God is fighting for me. No. We are children of God, but we are not ignorant.
Yeah. Amen.
The doctors, the scientists, they have been given the wisdom by God.
Yes.
Because there's things happening in this world. Because we are not of this world, but we are in this world.
Amen.
And we're going to deal with the things that are happening in this world.
Yes.
But it depends on us. Worry, how do we want to deal with these battles in this world? Are we going to fight it the world's way, or are we going to fight God's way? And he says, keep silent and remain calm. Stop speaking negative things. Remain calm. Watch what is coming out of your way. Watch what you are meditating on. So it's important to check, worry. What are we thinking about? What are we feeding our spirit? If it's negativity, only negativity will be in our mind. Only negativity will come out, or hopelessness out of our mouth.
Yeah.
And then, because God has a relationship with Moses, I think sometimes God speaks to us this way. Why are you crying to me? Moses and God had a relationship, and we have a relationship with God.
Amen.
So he's saying to Moses, as for you, lift up your staff and stretch your head over the sea and divide it. You know, Mudimu says Moses is the one who's doing everything. Stretch over your staff. I think you have a staff in your hand.
Yes.
Wow. Stretch your hand over the sea and divide it so that the sons of Israel may go through the middle of the sea on dry land. So in our battles, in our homes,
amen,
God has given us positions.
Wow.
I'm a leader in my home as a mother.
Amen.
I have a position and an assignment to fulfill. My husband is a leader. He has an assignment to fulfill.
Amen.
Provide, do whatever, I nurture, I do whatever. My children also. Live on them, they have an assignment. The ability to take instructions, to listen.
Yes.
You are the pastor in your region. You have been given an assignment to fulfill. Do not neglect it.
Yes.
Make sure that you fulfill it.
Yes.
Because if you don't fulfill our assignment as pastors, we're going to end up having casualties. People won't be able to cross the Red Sea because we failed to raise up our staff. If I fail to raise up my staff as a mother, I'm going to raise up another staff who can even pack themselves. Who can even cook? the Moses in my assignment. You are the Moses in your assignment. Let us go and find our stuff. Let us not be destroyed for the children of God while we have all the weapons. We cannot refuse to die. Refuse. And say, I'm gonna take up whatever that I have and I'm gonna face the Red Sea. If my life ends, that means, praise God, my assignment has ended. And I'm victorious. Death doesn't mean failure. That means your assignment is done. So let not death bring anxiety. Think for Mutimu does not exist. It's painful. It's painful. It is horrible to lose a loved one. We lost people a lot. But let us get up, move forward in victory. Because the battle does not belong to us, the battle belongs to the Lord. When the Red Sea is parted, that's evangelism.
Yeah.
Listen to what God says. Go, verse 17. He says, as for me, hear this. I will harden the heart of the Egyptians, and they will go in the sea after them. And I will be glorified and honored through Pharaoh and his army and his war chariot and horsemen. Every battle, every Red Sea that we cross successfully, it brings glory to God. Because people won't keep quiet. They will want to know, how did you cross over? How did you cross over? Because when you're facing a challenge, when somebody comes and gives you advice, you want somebody who has dealt with it so that you can refer you again. You cannot go to somebody and talk about your merit to somebody who's not married.
Amen.
He doesn't know. The person does not know what is happening. It may be something that they saw on TV or they read somewhere.
Amen.
So we are going to cross the Red Sea so that God can be glorified and honored. Because we have crossed over, we have moved forward, because victory is waiting for us.
Amen.
Amen. So, another thing,
thank you, Jesus.
We are not supposed to be afraid. We have to stand in firm as children of God. But everything requires action, Nazarbayan. Everything, we can confess, but everything requires action. So God speaks to Moses, and he gives Moses an instruction. Last year in August, I talked about the scripture of that woman. The husband died, and she was left with the dead. And then the people wanted their money, the creditors wanted to take the children. And then he went to the prophet of God.
Yes.
And the prophet of God gave her an instruction, and it required work. She had to go to the neighbors and ask for jars of oil, empty jars. That's when she experienced the breakdown. If I want a financial breakthrough, I'll pray until I turn blue. If I don't give, I cannot get a financial breakthrough.
Amen.
Those are the principles of God. Windows of heaven cannot be opened up by fasting and then I refuse to give. Because giving is a sign of obedience. My ability to take an instruction is a sign of obedience. Moses parted the Red Sea and the children of Israel crossed over. He did exactly what God told him. For the children of Israel to cross, you must raise your staff. God did not say, okay, raise your staff, and Moses went and prayed. And then the Red Sea parted. We cannot.
Amen.
We reap what we sow.
Yes.
You can't be able to get babies.
Yes.
We pray. Healing will come.
Yes.
Forgiveness will come. We confess our sins, forgiveness will come.
Amen.
If you don't confess your sins, you can tithe. But forgiveness won't come because you never confess your sin.
Yeah.
We will remain trapped whilst tithing.
Sure.
We will remain trapped in sin whilst tithing. Because the word of God tells us for us to receive forgiveness. There's a lesson in the act. Amen. So, the next point, what you need to do after taking action, is remember what God has done.
Amen.
Remember what God has done.
Yeah.
You know, when you remember what God has done, it strengthens you.
Yes.
It gives you courage. When we look at First Samuel, when we look at David, when he was going to face Goliath, can you please project First Samuel verse 17?
Thank you.
I was reading it in the beginning. So my Bible is. So we're going to read from 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 34 and 35, and read 45 to 47. Here we see a young man, David, who was anointed at 17. He was a shepherd. And as a shepherd, the children of Israel, you know, they always had an enemy, and the enemy was the Philistines. So now the Israelites are facing the Philistines. The Philistines, there's this giant called Goliath who has been in battle from a young age. He was huge, massive, like the problems that you face on daily basis. Some of them, they are so huge, you can't even see on the other side. So when David went to give food to his brothers who were in battle, and they were warriors and everything, because he was young and a shepherd, his father sent him there. When Afika Mole, there is this Philistine busy and insulting, who is instilling fear in the children of Israel. You know, the devil will push negative things so that you are paralyzed. You forget how strong you are. You forget who you are. So what happened here? As David went there, and then he had all this, and then the children of Israel are traumatized, and then so there was a negotiation. Whoever going to kill the Philistine, this is what they went to get, and Saul was the king at that time. So, chapter 4, by David said to Saul, "Your servant has been keeping his father's sheep. When a lion or a bear came and carried off a sheep from the flock, 34, I went after it, struck it, and rescued the sheep from its mouth. When it turned to me, I seized it by its head, struck it, and killed it."
Amen.
56. Amen. We're going to stop at the sheep. Yeah. So your servant has killed both the lion and the bear. This uncircumcised Philistine will be like one of them, because he has defied the armies of the living God.
Yeah.
Remember, Moses said to my brother Israel, stand firm, do not be afraid, be confident. This is confidence.
Yeah.
And this is the confidence that we are going to have, because we have a father who fights for us.
Yes.
The father who sees everything.
Amen.
Even when we are being treated unfairly, and then we don't see what is happening in the background, he sees everything. That's why we get things that we never asked for, because there's a battle happening in the background, and God is bringing things that he has placed in store for us. Please have any needs.
Right.
Amen. Can we go to 45? 45, please. David said to the Philistine, "You come to me with the sword and the spear and the javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the one of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied." Which name do you call? There's a powerful name that you have. That name is our stuff. That's the name that we raise.
Amen.
word.
Amen.
Action is the last thing. Moses spoke, and then after speaking, after winning the battle by talking, he went, just raised his head.
Amen.
Speak.
Yes.
My God.
And see what's going to happen. Yes. Speak, be confident.
Yeah. Amen.
Be confident.
Yes, Lord.
Qualifications, money, cool things that the world likes cannot win battles for us. People will open doors for you and they will close them because they open them. But when that name opens the door for you, nobody can close it. When that name shuts the door, nobody can open it. Can open the door. For the record is the Lord. Amen.
Amen.